Assalamu alaikum guys, welcome to my talk. This video is the continuation of the last video I posted. So if you haven't watched the first part, do check it out. I have shared the link in the comment section. Before starting, I would like you guys to press the subscribe button and bell icon too. Today we are going to discuss new relation in detail. So in the previous video, I talked about the basics of the new relation and its steps. In this video, I'll go in depth and we will cover few important points. So watch this video till the end. So new relation starts during the third and fourth week of development when the notochord induces the nearby ectoderm to elongate and form a neuroectoderm or neural plate during the third week of development. Then this neural plate bend and form neural folds, which then curve upward and form a neural tube. Let's talk about neural tube. A neural tube is a hollow tube which arises from the neuroectoderm under the influence of notochord. A neural tube has two ends, cranial and caudal end, which are not closed and called neuropores. These neuropores close from 4 to 6 weeks of development. What is a neuropore? A neuropore is an opening of the neural tube during the developmental phase. There are two types of neuropores, a cranial neuropore, which is going to form brain and its structure. A cranial end closes approximately around day 24. And a caudal neuropore, which is going to give rise to spinal cord. Let's talk about how cranial end of the neural tube develops into the brain. Cranial end closes approximately day 24 and cranial end forms three primary structures just after the closure of the neuropore. These structures are called primary brain vesicles, which are prosencephalon, mesencephalon, rhombencephalon, under the influence of different growth factors. Now these primary brain vesicles will give rise to secondary brain vesicles. So prosencephalon, which is going to give rise to telencephalon and diencephalon. Mesencephalon does not give rise to any secondary structure. Rhombencephalon will give rise to metencephalon and myelencephalon. We are not done yet, and I know neuroembryology is complex, but if you study the basics and steps, you will sure be able to learn it properly. Now these secondary brain vesicles will form normal brain structures, so let's talk about that. Telencephalon is going to form the cerebral hemispheres, basal ganglia, hippocampus, the corpus striatum, lamina terminalis and lateral ventricle. Diencephalon is going to form thalamus, hypothalamus, pineal gland, mammillary body, optic nerve and third ventricle. The primary brain vesicle mesencephalon is going to form midbrain and cerebral aqueduct. Metencephalon is going to form pons, cerebellum and upper part of the fourth ventricle. Let's talk about myelencephalon. Myelencephalon is going to form medulla and lower part of the fourth ventricle. As you can see in the diagram, how these vesicles form a perfectly normal brain and its structure. Let's talk about caudal neuropore now. So how does the spinal cord develop from the caudal end of the neural tube? Caudal neuropore closes on the 28th day of gestation. The neural tube has three layers from inside to outside, which are ventricular zone, intermediate zone and the marginal zone. Ventricular zone forms neuroblasts, which in the future form the nerve cells, and glioblasts, which are going to form supporting cells. Neuroblast and glioblast will migrate to intermediate zone and form alar plate and basal plate. They are separated by sulcus limitans. Cells in the alar plate is going to form afferent fibers or sensory neurons and the posterior horn of the spinal cord. The posterior horn will merge to form a dorsal median septum. Cells in the basal plate will give rise to efferent fibers or motor neurons and the anterior horn of the spinal cord. The anterior horn will bulge anteriorly and form a ventral median fissure. The lumen of the neural tube forms the central canal of the spinal cord. Let's talk about conus medullaris and why it is important to know about it. During week 8 of development, the spinal cord extends the entire vertebral column. So what is the cornus medullaris? Cornus medullaris is the tapered lower end of the spinal cord. At birth, it is at the level of L3 vertebra, and in adults, it extends to L1 vertebra. Spinal lumbar puncture is performed just below the level of cornus medullaris. That's it for the development of the central nervous system. Let's talk about the development of the meninges. So paraxial mesoderm around the neural tube give rise to the dura mater. Neural crest cells give rise to pia and arachnoid mater. Let's talk about neural crest cells. We already talked about neural crest cells in the previous video, but now we will talk about its derivatives. The remnants of the neural folds form neural crest cells, which then migrate to different parts of the body and give rise to few nervous structures, which are spinal ganglia or dorsal root ganglia, ganglia of ANS, meninges of brain and spinal cord, adrenal medulla, and nerve sheaths of peripheral nerves, and so on. That's it for the embryology, guys. I hope you guys find this video helpful. If you like this video, share it with your friends and do give your reviews in the comment section. If you have any questions regarding this topic, you can ask. That's it for today. Bas dua mein yaad rakhna. Allah Hafiz.